The creed continues. Not only did Jesus suffer, but he suffered under Pontius Pilate. Now there's a couple things to notice in this. First, it's interesting that it says he suffered under Pontius Pilate, because even the scriptural narratives, as much as we might want to clean them up or do something with them to remove the blood curse that some people have used over the years that say, well, it was all the Jews' fault, the Jews killed Jesus, which, yeah, there are allusions to that in the Gospels. We can't deny that they're there. But the creed, that which we Christians agree that we believe in, that says he suffered under Pontius Pilate. He suffered under a Roman form of punishment that was decreed by a Roman governor, and so he was killed by the power of the empire. Okay? He suffered under Pontius Pilate. Didn't suffer at the hands of quote-unquote those Jews who are albeit not the same as today's Jews anyway. Oh, this is such a rich field for discussion at some point. But he suffered under Pontius Pilate. Now, Pontius Pilate was well known in his day for being a really wicked guy, really awful. He's the one who had the heads of hundreds of Palestinians put on pikes on the side of the road to make an example of them, so that if anybody thought they could mess with Roman power, all they had to do was go there and they could see, this is what happens to you. See? You mess with the powers that be, and the powers that be will always be bigger than you. That's who Pontius Pilate was. So for him to kill, you know, one measly Palestinian might not have seemed all that big of a deal, except that Jesus had come in on Palm Sunday, remember? What we call Palm Sunday, to great acclamation. And Pontius Pilate must have known that there was going to be trouble if he saw to the killing of Jesus. Certainly Pontius Pilate's wife saw that. So we just want to note that. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, so let's put the accountability for Jesus' death where it actually lies, where it ought to be, with Rome, with the empire, and we can still see how people are made examples of today who mess with the powers that be. Until next time, when we talk about, yes, suffered under Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. We'll see you then.